Yeah.
So.
I think the history that's included in here, obviously that's factual information that really doesn't have anything to change. Can anybody think of anything that we missed on the history part? I did include what the specific council goal was that, I think maybe the word moving should not be capitalized. And then it talks about the CIC's responsibilities. What do you think, should we add in there who's on the CIC?
Yeah, I was going to say, I think one of the things is particularly since there's such misinformation out in the public in regards to the makeup of CIC, maybe even talk about, I mean, you've got on here what, you know, the CIC is responsible for, why it's there, it's the economic, it's there to aid, obviously, economic development for the city. But I think it would be important to note the five members and make it very clear that Jay Stewart is a resident of the city of Loveland. Pam Gross is a resident of the city of Loveland. Corey O'Donnell is a resident of the city of Loveland. Obviously, we have finance director. I know you are not, but you are. By law, we have to have two administrative people. You've got Carl, who's been a 30-year resident of the city of Loveland and owns a business here in the city of Loveland. 15-year
resident.
Oh, 15?
16.
16, sorry.
I'm 30. I'm not old enough.
You're not old enough, sorry. That's all right. No, Gail's not old enough.
Did you start the conversation? Did you start the conversation?
Yeah, so I think that's important that that information be corrected. But I think the rest, I mean, in terms of, you know, what the responsibilities are, I mean, I think it's pretty clear in here as you're reading this that all decisions in regards to any of this will be ultimately the decision of City Council.
Okay, let me read back what I have written and see if everyone's in agreement. The CIC is composed of a 5-member board consisting of Jay Stewart, Pam Gross, Corey O'Donnell, all residents of the city, City Finance Director Kelly Flanagan, and prior 15-year resident, 16-year resident, and current business owner.
In Loveland, in the city.
Owner in the city.
And actually, Corey and I both own businesses in the city of Loveland as well. So not only are we residents, we're also business owners here in the city.
You can wordsmith that.
Okay.
Yes, I was going to say, you don't have to get all wordy like that.
I'll make sure that a draft with the revisions prior to it going in the city council packet is sent out to committee members. What about under the analysis section? Analysis and fiscal impact, a lot of that goes hand in hand. I know we've been provided with a lot of great information, but I felt trying to include number projections of all three options with different variables such as vacancies, escrow, rental increases. I felt like that was a lot to try to include in a memo, especially when the slides are attached as a supplement to the memo. And you all should have also received the updated revised slides from Geis Consulting that included that two and a half option that was requested. I picked to look at the 20-year with a 10% vacancy, 1% annual increase in rent, and 20,000 annual maintenance escrow cost with both city ownership and joint venture. How do you guys feel about using those number projections? I felt like 10 wasn't going out far enough. 30?
Too far.
Too far. I think the 20 was a good, I think 20 years is good. I think 30 is too far.
Okay.
And 10, I agree, is too. Yeah.
And I did both the 2-story and 4-story only because I felt like those were both ends of the spectrum. And again, all of the detail regarding the in-between be in the slides.
Yeah, and I think I agree with that as well. It was interesting, we had a planning and zoning meeting last night, and in our planning and zoning meeting, the commissioners from the, all said four stories. So it was kind of funny. So I think that's a good, to have that in there, so.
Okay.
Yeah. And I agree, since obviously Jay is going to be doing the presentation, right, for the city, at city council meeting?
For the CIC, correct.
Okay, for the CIC. We will, I'm hoping all the members can be there next Tuesday.
That's gonna be next Tuesday?
Yeah.
And it's gonna start at 7 o'clock?
At 7 o'clock, yeah.
Is that when?
Jay will be.
No, is that when this part of the council meeting is gonna take place, or is it gonna be like later in?
No, he'll be right. The person's appearing before council.
Yeah, he'll be right up front.
Okay.
Yeah. And I agree that just to keep this, you know, short and sweet with this, it's gonna have, I mean, not only is he gonna do the presentation, it's gonna have the details with the slides and everything. And I think that people, you know, really wanna, you know, go through them, which people like me would. I think, I mean, all of us will, but I think if anyone wants to look at the actual details on it, I don't think it really needs to be in the memorandum itself. So I agree with what you did there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so when does the public discussion happen?
It'll be the following meeting.
If that's when city council sets the public hearing.
Right.
Okay,
yes.
And do you think, does city council think that that's the plan to make it for that? Okay.
Yeah, I don't see any reason why the public hearing won't be set for the next
council meeting.
Right.
2 weeks after the fact.
Right. Because we have to do that by law.
Okay.
So that we can do the outreach to the community so that they can come.
Yeah, and do you anticipate having more than one public session?
I would probably think we probably, well, the thing is, the process itself will lend itself to multiple public hearings.
So the reason I'm bringing this up is that, as we are all well aware, there's information out there that is purely not true.
Right.
I shouldn't even call it information.
It's
there are
not.
Statements out there that are purely not true. And I think that there is a portion of the community that believes that, as we said earlier, there's going to be a shovel out here next week. So I think it would be important if somehow we communicated what we think a reasonable timeline is for this to happen.
Well, I think part of what I anticipate will be the discussion at council. I think all of that will come up at the council meeting. I think the intent will probably be to have something that is an outline of what this project is, and what kind of great opportunity is and why it's a great opportunity. But I think also with that, it will include some kind of maybe FAQ sheet with questions that we anticipate that the public will come with that we can disseminate ahead of time so that some of the questions can be answered. And then as well as a timeline for the project itself. That's what I'm envisioning what will probably come out of. After Jay does his presentation, we're going to have a long discussion on this, and I would imagine that a lot of that is going to come out of the council meetings, which will also help, you know, guide us as well. But I would think that there would be a timeline in there. You know, here's what's next, and then the building will have to be demolished, and when it will be, you know, that just a you know, and the date of maybe when it would be, you know, completed. So I would think that all of that is going to eventually be done through council.
Okay, well then, a further question. I'm just anticipating questions in the next, you know, 60 days over this whole matter. What we're presenting to council is essentially the findings of our group, what Ken has put together, Carl's, all of our inputs. We present this recommendation to council. Is that any more than just a presentation to say, this is what we've found. Now, council, you decide really what you want to do. So it's like we started the process, but we're not committed to do anything. Is it? Do I understand that to be the case?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's the definition of recommendation.
days?
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, that's, well, we have to wait for council to come back and tell us.
And so I'm just taking this one step further, that, and I hate to harp on this, but all the things that I've seen on the videos and what I've read in the newspapers and so on, I just want to...
Now we're cooking with gas.
Here we are.